We're here at CJ's nightclub in downtown Kamloops. We're here to talk to you a little bit about Art Battle. More importantly, the city finals coming up on June 1st here at CJ's. Art Battle is a live painting competition that's happening nationally all across the country. It's actually been happening for 8 years, and this year, here in Kamloops, it's our first year joining Art Battle for season 8. We've been having Art Battles here in Kamloops every 6 weeks. The result is one champion of the night, and how we get there is we put 12 artists against each other, painting over 3 20-minute rounds. They paint whatever they want on the same size canvas with the same set of paints, and their job is to razzle and dazzle you to garner your votes to put them through to the city finals. Today we're going to talk to a few people about their Art Battle experiences. First of all, tell us a little bit about yourself as an artist, maybe what you like to paint, some of the preferred mediums you use, how you all got started.
Sure, yeah. I do a lot of portrait painting. Primarily I work in oils, but recently I've sort of made the transition back into acrylics. I hadn't painted in acrylics for a long time, and it's nice because everything's nice and quick, and it just makes everything really fun. So, and actually originally I'm from Penticton, I'm not from Kamloops, but I've been out here for about 3 years now, and really, really nice art scene out here. So
you participated in your first Art Battle here in Kamloops and you won the night. It was so much fun. Then we had you back for our special holiday event,
yeah.
Our 2 days and 20 minutes event. Again, you won the night. It's been awesome. Since then, you've been very generous and you've been helping out behind the scenes at Art Battle. Tell us a little bit about how this has affected you as an artist and your position here in the community.
When I first moved here, I wasn't actually really that involved in the arts community. But after that first Art Battle, I met a lot of really nice people and a lot of other artists. I made some really good contacts, and actually I'm working in Studio 322 on the 300 block of Victoria Street now, where there we do Red Room Paint Nights. Typically we do it every other Monday, so it's a really good opportunity for me to, you know, meet a whole bunch of other people and, you know, try and get more people involved in painting.
City finals is approaching. Mm-hmm. June 1st is very, very close.
Yeah.
What are you doing to prep for this? Where is your head at? Tell us a little bit about what's going on.
I do a lot of sketching now. Basically whenever I get, you know, a free couple minutes, maybe on the back of a napkin or something when I'm out getting a cup of coffee. If I see something that just sort of looks dynamic and I think it might translate well into a painting, usually I just try and jot it down somewhere so that I'm not going to forget about it. Just practice, I guess, and try and make sure that what's in your head can actually get onto the canvas. So.
So Cara, you've been to a couple of Art Battles before, which is fantastic. Tell us a little bit about your experience.
Well, going to an Art Battle was a great experience because A, you see a white piece of canvas being transformed into this amazing piece of artwork. Like there's six artists that are competing at one time, and then you go to another six artists, and then between those two battles there, the four of them come together and then they create another piece of artwork. So an artist is doing technically three pieces in one night in 20 minutes per piece, and it's just amazing how it happens. And then the buzz from people when they are, I guess you call it the tornado, going around and around and around. So 1 minute you go by, it's, you know, a few colors. The next minute you go by, there's more colors. And then the final piece, it's just, it's an awe piece, you know, it's great.
So tell me a little bit about how you feel this event differs from any other art event in town.
Well, one thing about this art event is that the energy that you get from the crowd that's watching the artists just gives a whole new level and maybe gets the adrenaline going for the artist. And when you are taking in an art exhibit, you're seeing finished pieces and you get to chat with the artist that has done that work, and you don't really know what they're going through because sometimes you're watching the artist paint and they're kind of getting fidgety or frustrated, and then all of a sudden they come out with an amazing piece of artwork. So I think that's what makes it so neat, is that the crowd creates the energy for the artist.
So with all of the different art battles that are starting to happen all across the province, there's definitely a big energy that's building here. How do you think that's going to affect Kamloops as a city, especially one that really prides itself on being the tournament capital of Canada?
Well, City of Kamloops is a major tournament capital, of course, right? We have like sporting events happening here every week. We have the Provincial Festival for Performing Arts coming up, and it's the competition that gathers a lot of people into town, and plus it's the economical benefit that we receive for tourists coming out of town to watch their friends compete in a national event. So bringing those other people from out of town just showcases our beautiful city that we have, and it elevates the culture here in Kamloops. You have athletes competing against each other, you have singers, dancers, chefs in the kitchen battling it out. Why not art? It's a great avenue for us to express ourselves and be creative.
You guys have been hosting it since day one. It's been amazing. What made you want to have this event here as the home for Art Battle?
I think we were trying to do different things with the community. There's a sort of glut in the downtown area, an opening for us to fill in terms of being more involved in the artistic community, and it was an opportunity that the owners were looking for, so we decided to support the event, and I'm glad we did, because it's turned into an amazing thing that happens here. So,
what kind of things have you heard from people who have attended the event here at CJ's? What's been their general feeling and response?
Yeah, we actually get a ton of great feedback from, especially on our Facebook site and on and through our website, from people who have come to the event. A lot of congratulatory kind of remarks. People want to see more of this, I think. There's a market for this kind of event in Kamloops, and up until now, it's a market that's kind of been mostly ignored. So I think people are excited to see this downtown. They're excited to see our local artists have an opportunity to be seen and to get their work out in public. And personally, I like it because it highlights Kamloops artists that maybe we wouldn't see in any other format. So I think it's an excellent opportunity for the artists, it's an excellent opportunity for the community, and it's something new for the community, and we need those kinds of things.
What would you say the vibe is like for the Art Battle event in comparison to some of your other events here?
I think the difference with Art Battle compared to, say, like a concert or one of those types of events is there's a surprise to it, right? When you come to a show, you know who you're seeing, you know the songs, that kind of thing. But with Art Battle, you don't know what you're going to see. You see things that are incredible. People who are you may not know or may not have seen in any other format in 20 minutes knock out something that's absolutely incredible. And I think that vibe makes it a really unique event, in that you don't have that kind of surprise with those kinds of events normally, but with this one, you've got 12 people competing and nobody knows what they're going to do. So it's unfolding live in real time with people milling around and yourself on the microphone. So I think it creates a really exciting environment, and it's just such a unique and very cool event that, I mean, we push it so hard on Facebook. I want people to come and see it. I want them to see how cool it is, and I want these local artists to be seen and have their work seen, because I think there's great value in that for the community.
If you want to know more about Art Battle, check out artbattle.com. Or if you want to know more about the city finals coming up on June 1st, check out the Facebook event page. Look for Kamloops Art Battle City Finals. My name is Michael O'Brien for Shaw TV.